Herkese iyi akşamlar. Şimdi çok değerli iki konuğum var. Seda Domaniç ve çok sevgili Olivia Palermo'ya bağlandık. Söyleşimizi başlatıyoruz. Zoom üstünden canlı yayındayız. Hi Olivia, welcome to the Mercedes-Benz Fashion Week Istanbul. It's a great pleasure to have you here, even it's virtually. I'm Rachel. You can call me Rachel as well. And also Seda Domaniç is here with us.
Hi, thank you so much for having me. It's such a pleasure. And
great
happy
to have
Fashion
you here.
Week.
Thank you. Once another Fashion Week here in Istanbul.
I know.
Yes.
We love Fashion Week.
We are so happy. So did you have time to watch any of the shows in the past few days?
You know what? What I'm planning to do is after every Digital Fashion Week, I go through and do them all kind of back to back in a row. And so instead of breaking it up and doing one a few days, I like to do it all together. And then it really helps you kind of create your sense of like the trend reports and putting, you know, connecting the dots from all the different cities of what we see on the runways.
So you'll still have to go back and watch everything, but I see that you're actually wearing a beautiful Nihan Peker dress, and I think you styled it really nicely. I think it's a great inspiration for all of us because normally it's a full dress. I think you put like a tank top in it and made it a little bit more contemporary. I love it. But
thank you. A little couture at home, you know,
exactly.
The best version of yourself.
you look like a delicious candy. You are so sweet. I should ask.
Well, you both look beautiful as well.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Olivia, you're a woman of many hats. You know, you basically, you're iconic tastemaker, and then you are also, you've been modeling, you do many design collaborations with important brands. So I know that it's so difficult to differentiate nowadays in this crowded space to make your brand known. And here in Istanbul, we have 30 independent designers joining with us Istanbul Fashion Week. Some of them are well established regionally, but some of them are really trying to make it in the international scene. So I want to ask you as an expert, how and where do you find new brands? Where do you discover them? I mean, what's your advice for these emerging brands? How should they stand out?
I'm always looking for new brands, my team and I, it's so important to go be physically present in all the different markets. And so for myself, I love to go into all the showrooms and have market appointments and see, you know, what the communications are, you know, representing. And I think, you know, throughout now and this period of time in fashion, you definitely see brands that have the heritage that are going to stay around for a long time. And you have some newer opportunities of new brands. And I think that that's great because, you know, within the world that we're living in now, I'm always for change is good and for the positive. So we have to make room for newcomers. And, you know, it's a time where you can feel inspired and to change your career. And I am totally all for, you know, someone going into the fashion industry and trying to make it on your own. I think it's really important to make sure that you have a clear direction and a clear message and clear brand values before starting anything. You really have to love it and live and breathe it and, you know, wake up every day, although it's a job, but you absolutely love it. So it doesn't feel like a job.
Yes, for sure. I think Rachel.
Yes. Rachel, change is good.
Change is very good.
Rachel,
yes, change is very good. So after the effect of COVID-19, what do you think about the future of fashion?
I think right now, you know, everything is kind of scaled down, which I think is a good thing. I think that the, you know, people are reshifting their business plans and their business models. And as I said, it's a good time for change and taking a look at where the industry is going. And I think, you know, every day it's a new learning experience and, you know, we're getting back on, you know, an old track, but I think that there is room for new emerging, designs and designers and business plans. So I'm really excited to see what the future holds, to be quite honest. I was in Europe for a little bit for Fashion Week, and it's really telling that the, you know, the brands that have incredible heritage and craftsmanship are the ones that are really sticking around, which is really nice to see.
It's true. I think exactly. It's important that they're sticking around, but at the same time, I feel like at least this whole digital experience has given a chance for less lesser known fashion weeks or lesser known brands to be in a way discovered, because you know, before it was like the major events were there, and then everyone was talking, you know, like we were all sitting at the front row all together, and it was difficult to have people come over to, let's say, Istanbul, or sometimes into Shanghai or Moscow. But now, with all these borders lifted, I just feel that there's almost an upside for lesser known brands and also for lesser known regions for to make it into a global scene. So I see that. Do you think this is an advantage?
I definitely think so. You know, because through our fashion month, our schedules are super tight, whether that's going to shows, presentations, or even just having our lookbooks that we see or go through our re-sees. And it's nice to kind of have that digital lookbook to kind of reference back, and it gives you time to see other designers as well that you wouldn't necessarily physically get to see. So I think, to your point, that that's really true. But it is so important for our industry for us to be in person and see the craftsmanship and see, you know, the designers and speak to the designers in person and see their team and their mood boards and everything. You know, that whole experience, that's such a physical one. You can't digitize that.
To be honest, I do miss physical fashion weeks to a certain point. I mean, I thought they were getting a little repetitive. It was like almost Groundhog Day. We were living this, you know, similar experiences over and over. So we needed to get creative with the way runways are presented, collections are presented. But of course, at the same time, you do miss that human touch. And actually, you just miss going out to a nice dinner after a nice show and just feeling all that sensory experiences. The music is there.
The crowd is there. Energy. You know? The energy of fashion.
Exactly. Olivia, can you share with us your most unforgettable Fashion Week moment?
Oh, I've had so many. It's hard to pick. Most unforgettable. I would probably have to say, I think my first Fashion Week when I was in New York, when I first started out. Of course, your first fashion show and Fashion Week is, of course, the one that you do remember and it resonates with you. And I was, I went to Zac Posen's collection when he was designing
beautiful clothes.
Yes, exactly, in Bryant Park, and it was incredible because it's very theatrical and whimsical, his collection then. So that was really nice. But you know, throughout my years, I've been so fortunate to, you know, go to incredible shows and see incredible production. So I really think that, within any city, it's unique within itself, and you can't really necessarily compare. You appreciate everything for the beauty of it.
Well, I really hope that we return to those moments soon. But I think the digital will continue. I mean, we all discussed that it will be digital because we can't really go, because digital does have its advantages. I mean, reducing the footprint, really making everyone to be able to sit at the front row. I mean, eliminating all those barriers and all that, you know. So it does have some advantages for sure.
But it's also great for designers to scale back as well and to take that budget and really focus in on the collection and building the brand as well, I always find.
I know that you miss traveling because I think you were probably on the road more than you were home before, right? Going all these fashion months. Then we 100%. Had to do we loved and had to do the resort collections going all around the globe, basically to these beautiful places where they hosted the shows. But, you know, with this, I wonder if you ever made it to Turkey. Have you ever been here?
Yes, I have. And I've actually celebrated my birthday. Johannes it was with me. I've worked for a few clients in Turkey, and so I've had some really great times. I've been there for like two, three days, so not so in and out. I think when my first trip was a bit shorter, but it's really nice. And I've gone, of course, in the winter and the dead cold of February. So yes.
I've been in Istanbul. Any other city?
No, unfortunately not. But I really do hope to.
Once this pandemic is over, we'll make you a list, and then we'll have Cappadocia.
Yes,
will be on top of your list, I think, after Istanbul.
Exactly. You should visit Cappadocia.
I'm sure you've traveled to Turkey and also to this part of the world. I just want to, you know, pose this question to you: how do you think the way in which Turkish women put fashion together, or Middle Eastern women, or you know, North Eastern or Mediterranean women put fashion together, what are your observations?
I think everybody is so beautiful, and I think it's always so inspiring to see telemarketer. I think it's so
digital hazards.
These telemarketers, they just keep calling me left and right. I don't know how they get my number.
You get a telemarketing call? That's funny.
Yes, I constantly. Since COVID, I get about 30 a day. It's really irritating. Before I had zero.
Okay, well, anyway, the way the woman here around that you observe.
Just super sexy, elegant, has lots of confidence in the way that they carry themselves. The glamour is just always flawless with the makeup and hair. It's always so beautiful.
There's a little here, right? I mean, if you're from New York, but I think you do spend some time in Berlin too, right? If I'm wrong.
I do. I spend time. I spend some time in Berlin and in Hamburg. I spend lots of time in Paris and London as well. Most of my friends all live in Europe, so in the evenings in New York, it's quite quiet for me here in New York.
I think there's a bit of more effortlessness in the US than once you come to this part of the world. I think women do like making an effort, you know. I think it's in our genes to make a little bit of effort. You look Rochelle, you know, she's always so immaculate, but I think you do have an impeccable taste too, you know.
Yeah,
you're known for your impeccable taste and always always looking great. Is it, I'm just going to ask this, this was not on, you know, like planned, but is it difficult to maintain this perfect outlook all the time?
You're so kind. You know, my mother really instilled at a very young age always, and my baby nurse who raised me, it's so important to know, you know, to be always dressed appropriately, and you have, you know, your work clothes, you have your party clothes, you have your, you know, time off clothes, but it's really always important to look the best version of yourself. And even if that means getting on a 4 o'clock flight, you know, the day will start by when you land. And so you need to look appropriate and ready to go. So that is always what my mother has instilled to me. And I can't stress it enough. It's so important. And it sets your mindset and, you know, a ready to go start your day state.
Perfect. I have one last question.
Yeah.
For you. Can you complete the following sentences? I would love to sit between blah, blah, and blah, blah during a fashion show.
I would love to sit between Sarah Harris, my best girlfriend, and my best guy friend, Lucas Somoza, because we have a great laugh. And if Lucas is unavailable, then I'll pick my dear friend, Godfrey Houdini. He's incredible. And we always are giggling in the corner when we're sitting next to each other.
It's a nice choice.
Some interesting comments about the shows and collections, right? Beautiful.
Absolutely.
You know, sometimes I did feel like we were like in school at those fashion shows. It was like going back to school. It was a school starting, you know, almost, because you
it's
see
it's true.
Everyone.
That's what I call it as well. It's like you see everyone in September is going back to school. Everyone enjoyed their summer. They're all very happy to see each other. And I think even now more so than ever, I think the, you know, the community is so ready to get back together and, you know, enjoy each other's presence.
Perfect. Well,
one last one.
Michelle, yes.
Sure.
No, please.
My secret beauty trick during fashion week is
you just cut out, sorry.
I think she was asking you about your beauty trick, because Rochelle,
my beauty trick, I'll tell you, it's my glam fam. It's my glam fam. It's Charlotte and Nelson and Ben. They keep me looking fabulous. But it's important to sleep and drink lots of water, and I use SK2. It really just brightens up my face.
Perfect. I think I definitely got a lot of great advice.
Good. Well, let me know. I always have tons more.
Yes, I'll take your advice about the early morning flights. I'm in a loungewear, you know.
never for me. That I keep it at home. But you know what? You trust me. You wake up early, and no matter what time it is, you'll feel really great by the time when you get to the airport.
Thank you so much, Olivia, for these.
Thank you, ladies.
And we would love to have you with us.
Great to have you.
I would love to come next time, and I hope to see you both really soon, and enjoy the rest of Fashion Week.
Hopefully we'll see you in person soon somewhere around the globe.
I would love that.
Ciao. Bye-bye.
Ciao. Bye.